Hi, welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial I will show you how to do a waving flag animation in DaVinci Resolve 16. First of all, let's go to the effects library, select solid color and drag it to the timeline. Let's change the duration of the clip. Right-click, change clip duration, and we'll go with 30 seconds. Next, we need to convert it to a new compound clip. So right-click, new compound clip. Let's name it waving animation. Now let's move to the fusion part of DaVinci Resolve 16. First, we delete the Media 1 node. Let's do some arrangements. Right click, arrange tools to grid so that everything snaps to the grid. Let's add a flag image. I have downloaded an American flag PNG from pixabay.com. It will provide you with a link in the description. Drag the flag image to the nodes area. Select the media in one and click number one on the keyboard so that the flag shows on the left screen. Next, we need to add an image plane 3D, so control space, type image plane 3D and add it to the nodes. If you click the image plane 3D and hit number 2, you will see the flag is in a 3D plane on the right screen. Now control space, let's add the displaced 3D node. The displaced node goes after the image plane 3D node. The next thing we need to do is to add a fast noise node. So control space, add the fast noise and link it to the displaced 3D node. With the fast noise keyboard, then you will see the fast noise on the left screen. Now select the displaced 3D and click number 2 to see it on the right screen. We adjust the noise properties. We will change the scale. We can see that we can see what the detail property does. You can change the contrast and brightness by changing the sliders. You can also check the angle. Now we will play with the center X and Y values of the noise. As you can see, click near the center word, go to modify with the select, and select the shake option. Now if we could quickly play the animation, this is what we get, but it doesn't really look of what we want to achieve, so control Z or control Z to undo it. Now right click again next to the center word and select expression. This will allow us to change the X and Y center position. We want to move the X and Y points of the center by time, so as the animation plays, the X and Y change accordingly. For that, we write time after the first bracket and again time as the second parameter of the point function. When we play the animation, we see that it is playing very fast, and that is not what we want. To have it play slower, we divide the time parameters by a number. We will go by 100 for both of the parameters. When we play animation again, we get a bit better waving animation. Now what we need to do is to add a merge 3D node, camera 3D, spotlight node, and an ambient light. To do that, we have to select the displays 3D node. With the node selected, hit Control Space. Write merge 3D and add it to the node. Then we select the merge 3D node, Control Space, and add the camera 3D. Select the merge 3D again, Control Space, and add a spotlight node. And also we will add an ambient light, Control Space, type ambient light, and add it to the nodes area. Now we add a render 3D, Control Space, render 3D, add it to the nodes area. Select the render 3D node and we change the render type from software renderer to OpenGL renderer. Enable the lighting and shadows by checking lighting and shadows in the lighting section. Select the render 3D node and hit 2 on the keyboard. On the right screen we see a blank screen. Adjust the camera to have everything show up. Select camera 3D node, change the Z value of the translation settings. You need to change the Z value until you get the flag to cover the whole screen. Select the spotlight node, adjust the Z value for it as well. We see that the spotlight is taking effect now. Now we adjust the other spotlight settings. All we want to achieve is get something that will look like a darker edges effect. Now, as you have noticed, the image playing 3D specular effect is too strong. To soften or remove it, we select the image playing 3D node and in the material section go to specular, change the intensity to 0. Next, we change the ambient light properties, change the intensity to 0.22. We will also change the translation z value. We select the fast noise again. We change the expression time divider to 50 so that the waving animation plays a little bit faster. Now we will change the scale value to 0.9. Also change the angle and seed values. Now change the detail, contrast, and brightness values of the fast noise. And we play the animation. Now select media one node, control space, and add prism blur. Select the newly added prism blur node and show the renderer node in the right screen. Let's adjust some prism blur settings. As always, play around with the settings until you get the desired result. After doing all the changes, you can play the animation to see the changes. So we play the animation now. Select fast noise node again and change the brightness to somewhere like this. Go to the camera 3D and adjust the translation Z value. Now we go to the render 3D node and we connect it to the media out and hit number 2 key. Go to the edit section of DaVinci Resolve 16 and You may notice that the animation might not play smoothly from the beginning because it requires some time to do a fully render, so it depends on your computer configuration. And this is a waving flag animation we just made. It is not perfect, but if you play around with all the settings I have shown you, you can get an even better effect, even better animation. So now we can try to add another flag to this. And changing the flag is very easy. Start by deleting the media in node. Then drag the other image to the screen. The other flag is also downloaded from the pixabay.com. Link is in the description. Connect media into the prism blur. Return to edit section of DaVinci and play the animation again.